Welcome to Six Sigma Mania. FMEA is one of tools that helps us understand potential failures in the processes, failure causes, and their effects. By understanding this, we can focus on reducing all these not needed influences. FMEA is an acronym that stands for Failure Mode and Effect Analysis. There are different FMEA types: functional, design, and process FMEA. We use team experiences with similar products, processes, or common sense logic to estimate failure probability. There is FMEA worksheet available under the video. Or visit my blog for more detailed information, or to download other different Lean Six Sigma templates for free. Here are some rules to follow when creating FMEA. Identify process of one product you would like to review. Try to address entire process under your control. Divide it if it is too wide. You can use value stream map or process map for process identification. If you are running improvement project, address processes within project scope. Process mapping can help you with identification. Do not solve whole facility at once. Plan this activity in advance. People must count with it in their schedule. Work as a team. Invite at least one person from assessed process, as well as colleagues from different departments. Visit and observe assessed process. Walk to see is key to reveal possible failures. Do not hesitate to ask questions while observing. It is a little boring, but you will create and fill table. Write down each process step. There can be several potential failures in each step. Personal observation will help you not skipping anything. Occurrence defines how likely failure will occur. Severity ranks failure effect. Detection ranks how likely failure will be noticed. Rank all three categories by 1 to 10. 1 for the lowest, and number 10 for the most negative impact. Work in teams to rate probability severity and detection number for each potential failure. Risk preference number is calculated by multiplying all three numbers together. FMEA is a living document. It is key to review it on a regular basis. You can start with yearly reviews. It is good to have notes written next to each number for these future reviews. Simply explain why you have chosen such a number, and people reviewing FMEA will be thankful for it. Now it is time to address and try to reduce the biggest risks based on final RPN. Use this decision table for action and measures determination. Start addressing potential failures with high risks first, then medium risks. Briefly review also acceptable ones just to be sure not missing any potential troublemaker. Here is FMEA example on tires exchange. Out of three potential failures, one have high RPN, one is with medium, and one acceptable risk preference number. Do not hesitate to simply describe each potential failure. Actions, also called countermeasures, must be bulletproof to decrease risk to minimum level. Like torque air gun usage, in the case of bolts not tight properly potential failure. Now it is time to implement described actions. Identify owners, set a due dates. Meet regularly to check out progress on implementation activities. Take a look under the video, where you find a link to my blog, to download FMEA and reaction matrix templates for free. Use it, share it. I post Lean Six Sigma and project-oriented videos regularly, so if you find this video helpful, give us a like. And do not forget to subscribe. Stay safe, and have a great day.